Hello guys, welcome to a new episode of DIYRC to the Eachine E016H FPV modification. In the last episode we upgraded the range to 100 meters that you really need as you're gonna start flying FPV because you have absolutely no idea how far away you're flying. But I want to be flying FPV and still keep the same flight performance from the little Eachine E016H because I was loving it the way it performed. But each gram you're going to add is going to affect how the drone flies. I already know that the drone can take and carry a lot of weight, seeing the heavy big battery it carries. So I also see a lot of room where we can save weight. So we can add the camera and keep the same flight behaviors like we had in the review when the drone was still completely stock. That was one of the big problems you had with the Eachine E10 and the E11, even after upgrades. The tiny 4 gram camera affected the way the drone fly. A lot, but this Eachine E16H with the altitude hold flies super stable, so I'm really looking forward how it's gonna be flying with the drone camera, with the FPV camera, because all to me it looks like it's going to be perfect to fly indoors, super stable. Now let's get to it and see what the weight is of the drone, and this is with the battery, 29.5 grams. Here I got the second battery. How much does the battery weigh? 10.7 grams. And here I got an upgraded battery. It's a little bit smaller. It's only 300 mAh instead of 350, but it's a higher C rating, 40C. So let's see how much. 8.2. So I'm saving 2.5 grams. And I'm keeping the same flight time and even maybe a little bit more power because it can deliver more amps if the motors want to draw it. Now let's put the FPV camera on. Let's see how much weight I need to save. 4.1 gram. I'm gonna get off the connector, so that's gonna be the one. So it's gonna keep 4 grams. If we're going to have to save from 29.5, gonna need to be 25.5. Put the new upgraded battery in. You can find the links, of course, down below in the description. It weighs 27 grams. There's still 1.5 grams to go. Canopy, hard plastic, it's gonna be 0.5 gram. Maybe that light, that's gonna be 1 gram, maybe even more. Wow. Let's open the drone and set some weight. Now let's see how much that canopy weighs. 2.6 grams. Wow, that's super heavy. Well, that means that we can even keep the light. That would be nice and makes it more visible if we lose the drone in a far distance. And that's also a very common problem you get when you're flying FPV with a micro drone. So I reached my target and I've made saved more than 4 grams. So if I want, I can also go ahead do the light, but I see still a bunch of connectors that weigh a lot. You can remove the connectors and just solder the wires directly to the circuit board. But let's get some double tape and stick the FPV camera on and test the equipment. You want to keep it in the center, keep it in the center of gravity as good as possible. Right over the wires, not so good, but I hope it's not going to create any problems. And then you have to stick the camera on top, but before we have to solder the wires, of course. And this is the E16H FPV completely done, or almost completely done, because double sided tape is not really enough to keep the camera still. It's wobbling around a lot. You can use a small rubber band for it, but I don't have those. I'm just gonna be using some. A little bit of isolation tape will do the trick. I can also put some extra piece of foam there to make the camera look up. It's all good. Ready for flying FPV, but the really interesting thing to see now is how heavy it is with the whole package completely done. Did I save the weight that I had foreseen with the upgraded Nanotech 300 mAh battery that saved me 2.5 grams? Then removing the canopy is 28.2. That is I'm saving 1.3 grams from the stock weight. So it's going to be flying even better with the camera on it. That's just amazing. So I can even put the stock batteries back in place and be what? About a gram over. 30.7, less about 0.5 gram, no, 1.2 grams heavier. I don't think you're gonna notice that 1.2 grams. So you can even use flying the stock batteries and have an absolutely great time flying it. So let's go. Drone is flying very stable and can carry this weight. You almost don't even feel that it's carrying the FPV camera. I'm just lining up for the first gap. And no problems at all. I'm seeing a nice gap at the left, but that's the most difficult gap, the concrete block. So we go for the play yard. Not some of the speed and the movement reaction of the drone. Again, trying that gap, but I got a little bit of a headwind that makes it really difficult. Pretty smooth. Going with the wind, it goes pretty fast. Downwind. And again, trying to get. It doesn't always work out perfectly, but it's so small, you can make some really nice gaps with it. It makes life a lot easier than with the bigger drones. And I'm liking it. I'm very liking it. You can see how stable it flies. There's absolutely no problem carrying the FPV camera. But yeah, I'm stubborn and I try to keep on trying to make that really difficult gap and showing you how good this drone is, but it's just not doing it. But again, there are more gaps and this is really difficult and it shows how good that altitude hold works and just keeping me just scraping the floor. It's very impressive. I really like it. Easy to control, easy to make those nice gaps. And I'm just gonna cry out some crazy stuff, but that doesn't always work. Better go up there, land, and then slide down, and then fly up again. This is a pretty nice gap. Whoop, whoop. And another one. Pretty big one, of course. And now you can see some of the speed that we're going. It's pretty nice. Downwind. And I tried to land at my table, but that's going wrong. I hope you really like this flight. I hope you like this FPV mod. You will find the links to this drone and the FPV gear that we use down below. And this was something that we came across going to the FPV flying test flight area. Just a piece of nature. We're like in the middle of nowhere. What can I say? You don't see this every day. I hope you like this video and subscribe so you don't miss out the next episode. And I want to thank you for watching. Goodbye.